Welcome back. Let's check in with Mike Eppel, see what he did for Thanksgiving weekend. Good morning to you. How are you?
Hello. Thank you.
Excellent. You did the turkey.
Yeah. Yep. Did it yesterday.
And you cooked it.
It was just, I did.
Excellent.
I did the whole meal myself.
Did you honestly?
Yeah, I did. I had nothing better to do.
That's impressive, though. You didn't recruit the kids or?
Yeah, no. The kids, sure. They helped clean up, I'll say that much. They were doing other stuff. But yeah, it was such a different Thanksgiving, I thought. It was so quiet. We didn't have people over. We didn't go to my in-laws. You know, we went to the farm for Saturday and Sunday, did some work there, stayed away from people, you know, and just kind of kept to ourselves. It was very different. Now we've got tons of leftovers, so
turkey
I'll send you some.
For everyone. Thanks, Mike.
Pretty much.
Thank
I'm a big
you.
Fan of soups.
Yeah, you know what? The thing is, though, no one felt like they were missing out on anything because everyone was in the same boat. So at least you feel that togetherness in the sense that we're all separate, if that makes sense.
Pretty much. And you know what? Also, we missed a fall fair. The Simcoe County Fair is typically, Norfolk County Fair was on this past weekend other years, but it didn't happen, right?
So, yes, that's
again,
sad. I love those fairs. I love
exactly.
them. All right, let's get down to business. We're talking rents and apparently still pretty high in Toronto.
Yeah, but the rental rates are coming down. Another indication that, you know, the demand for smaller apartments and condos, we've talked about condo listings in the real estate market going sharply higher, Melanie, in this study by rentals.ca, indicating that rental costs are coming down because, again, we're seeing this shift in the market. People are looking for more space. So depending on what you've got in the rental space, if it's a larger apartment, those prices are going up. Smaller units are coming down. So people looking for more space again. But what's the ripple effect? If you've got a condo, let's say it's 600 square feet, you own that condo, you want to rent it out to cover your mortgage. If you can't rent it for the price you were getting previously, does that again tip the balancer in the condo sales market?
Nice.
Something to watch.
Mm-hmm. Something we're watching as well. Apple and the new phone. I can't keep up with all their new technology. Honestly, I have no idea.
This will be iPhone 12.
Okay, this is 12.
This is 12. and they're going to be showing this off today in a virtual event because nobody can get together. But the talk is it's all going to be about 5G. And is this the start of a new super cycle for Apple because people will want to upgrade? Previously, it's like, do I need a new phone? Does it have enough different differences than the previous model, or am I still happy with that? This might be another one of these game changers for Apple. But look, we're 73 days away, or 73 shopping days from Christmas, I think it is.
Come on.
I've lost track. No, I'm not kidding. You can look it up.
I won't. You know I won't.
Apple will have some surprises. You got to figure. There was talk about some sort of a device you stick on your keys, for example, to track them if you lose them, which would be handy for me personally.
Yes.
Apple was up 5% yesterday, climbing another 2% this morning. And I don't know why all of a sudden the market's buying up Apple because it's not like this wasn't unexpected, I suppose, for lack of a better description. Anyway.
While we're talking about shopping, so people might be logging on to Amazon Prime Day for some Prime deals.
Yeah, and of course, this was the Prime Day events pushed back from the middle of the summer to now because of the COVID-19 outbreak. So again, does this take the place or pull forward shopping trends that we would typically really see focused on American Thanksgiving weekend, which this year might not be what it was previously because you don't want to go to mall. They don't want you to go into the malls, right? So Amazon's today, Best Buy's having a big sale, Walmart, Target, and I'm probably forgetting a bunch of others, but they're all online today. So if you see your coworkers and or you see worker productivity dropping, it's probably because people are clicking on various websites and maybe starting their Christmas sales or shopping earlier. Although I just saw another study just come in this morning saying that Canadians aren't going to be spending as much. Look, job insecurities out there, right?
Yes.
So that's going to, again, adjust a lot of trends this shopping season, which, again, might be starting today.
But also if you're not exchanging the gifts in person and you have to do it online, are we going to do that anymore?
You make a good point. You don't need as, you know, the grandiose showing under the tree of all of these packages because maybe you're shipping them instead of piling them up.
I don't know.
Again, everything is up for change,
interpretation and change,
yeah.
All right, Mike, well, just make your list, check it twice, and then I'll see what I can get for you today, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, have a